One of the most popular movies, at least online, to come out this year has been Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. It has been praised by its ravenous fan base and called the masterpiece, and anyone who's criticized it has been accused of just wanting to be different. And you want to know what I think about this movie? Do you really want to know what I think about this movie? I think it's okay. Now, I apologize if this video seems a little bit unstructured. I know I titled it a rant, but it literally will be a rant since I don't have a script. So, yeah, the reason why I decided to make this video is just because I thought the movie was just okay. And, you know, I know this is kind of dead. It's probably not going to get me any views, which I already don't have any views, but whatever. Because, you know, it came out like a couple months ago, and now it's like a dead meme. No one gives a shit anymore, but, you know, I still see things about this movie, and every once in a while, I just kind of think about it. I kind of think about it, and why it's kind of overrated. And I hate that term, but there's not really a better one for me to use here. A YouTuber I like named Cartoon, she made a tweet about the new TMNT movie, and he used the phrase Spider-Verse, like, you know, like he used it in a way to imply that it's some sort of golden standard in storytelling in comparison to other movies, and that really shows me how high of a pedestal this movie is on, to the point where it's become like the Citizen Kane of animation, where people will use it as being, you know, will use its name as being synonymous with quality. And its fans are kind of obnoxious, and I don't really like them that much. And when I say fans, I don't mean people who just enjoyed the movie. I mean people who talk about it a lot and have, you know, characters from the movie as their profile picture. Not that there's anything wrong with that for most other things, but it is with this one because they're annoying. And really, anytime I see someone criticizing the movie, even lightly, like just like valid criticism, they say, you're wrong, you're trying to be different, as if people can't have a different opinion genuinely. And it's all, you know, they act like you can't dislike this movie validly, and if you don't like it, you're just trying to be different from others, and there's no way to validly criticize it. And I have a feeling that a lot of these people, if they watch my video, which they might because I have 7 subscribers, you know, if these people do see this video, they're probably gonna shit on me, probably just kinda say that I'm trying to be different or I have objectively bad taste, and I don't really give a shit. Now, before I get into anything from the film that actually matters, I want to talk about the stupid culture war shit and about how this movie is criticized by a lot of people on the right for its political messaging. And I'm going to be completely honest, I kind of don't care. I hate culture war stuff in general, but I do think it is kind of a problem. Not a big enough one for it to really make the film that much worse, but it's just kind of cringe, I guess. So I guess I thought I might as well address it. There's a character in the film who is supposed to be Spider-Woman, and she's pregnant, and she fights a wall pregnant, and that's really stupid, you know? Like, I get they're trying to be progressive, but why would you have a pregnant woman in an action role and, like, not address anything about it? Like, won't she get a miscarriage? You know, should she be careful to make sure her baby doesn't come out as a slushy of blood? Like, that's kind of stupid, I guess, and just annoying. It's very Californian. The character Spider-Punk also constantly references anarchism, and that's his, like, only personality trait. That's kind of another issue of the film, but, yeah, it's kind of annoying, and it's kind of cringy that they're, I feel like this is what the people who actually made the movie believe, and they're just trying to, like, signal it to the adults in the audience, or, I guess, man-children more appropriately. And he references fascism, like, not, like, literally the word. He talks about how he hates the fascism, or whatever, and it's just kind of cringe. You know, I see this shit on Twitter all the time, but, you know, when I'm going to a movie about Spider-Man, I don't want to hear Twitter lingo and shit about fascists or whatever. It's just kind of annoying. And there are also some kind of subliminal kind of things about BLM or trans kids protect them or whatever. Yeah, stuff like that. Now, I would rather this not be in the movie, especially since it's like, it's kind of a kids movie, you know? you know, it's a movie for families, and it's like, I don't know, man. If I was going to go see a movie with my kid, I wouldn't want one of the characters to mention fascism, a bunch of fascists or some shit like that. You know, it's like, I wouldn't want that, but it really isn't that much of an issue because, you know, even though it's kind of cringe, it's all in character. You know, the characters are supposed to be punk rock, and punk rock people don't like fascism, unless you do, but that's kind of a different story. I can believe that Gwen Stacy supports trans rights, or that Miles Morales supports BLM, so it's like, I can believe that, you know. I mean, the pregnant Spider-Woman thing is kind of unforgivable, but, you know, outside of that, it's not that big a deal, and it doesn't really affect the movie too much. It's not like Ghostbusters 2016, where the political culture war shit is, like, a really important thing when talking about the movie. Here, it's just kind of a side thing that I just felt like I needed to mention before actually talking about valid criticisms of the movie. It's just because it was kind of a thing when it came out, and I just felt like I should, you know, give it my two cents. It's not great, but I guess compared to other movies, I handle it kind of decently, so. Now, I'm going to talk about the stuff that I actually liked about the movie, because, again, I said it was okay. I never said it was bad, so I just want to talk about the shit that I like. And the most obvious one is the animation. Again, the animation in this film is genuinely amazing. When it starts getting more action-oriented in the second half, it really gets to shine in the third act where they go to this rainy city and shit. It's really beautiful. It's beautiful looking. I guess maybe not beautiful traditionally, but it's really well done and it looks really cool and it's just a... It's great to watch, and personally, I think the entire reason why I like this movie is the action and the animation. Again, the action is fun. It gives off this kind of like Gurren Lagann kind of, Gurren, I don't think that's how you pronounce it. It gives off that kind of vibe of like really stupid yet entertaining action scenes and stuff. It's very fun. It's very fun to watch. You know, it takes a little while to get into that, but once he starts fighting all the Spider-Mans and big Hispanic Spider-Man, I fucking forgot his name. Wait a minute. You know, once he starts fighting Miguel O'Hara, you know, it's fun. It's really fun to watch, and I didn't genuinely enjoy that. It had great animation, and, you know, I guess I did appreciate the references. They weren't super shallow, I guess. I guess the people here do care, but, yeah, I guess that's actually it. That might sound like I'm kind of cutting the movie short, but, you know, the action and the animation are good enough to carry the film and make it, like, a 7 or a 6 out of 10 in my head. You know, it makes it a movie that is worthy of watching, so. Also, I did like the Spot as a villain. He's very mundane. I didn't think he'd actually be the actual, like, main villain in the film, because, again, he's kind of like a Z-tier villain. I didn't even know he existed before this film, but I feel like I kind of like that. It makes Miles feel more, you know, friendly neighborhood and stuff, you know? It's neat. It's very neat. He's not super funny, but I just kind of liked how they took like a kind of normal, you know, villain of the week kind of guy and made him the main antagonist. Okay, I've spent enough time stalling. It's time to complain. It's time for me to go in depth and go anal into the reasons why I think this movie is just okay. It's not a masterpiece. I'm really trying to nail that in, but I still think the movie is good. I just don't think it's that good. Okay, guys, calm down. Calm down. Now, I think the main thing that really makes this movie not as good as it could be is that it has awful, awful pacing. It doesn't pace out all of its events very well, and it's kind of obvious because the movie doesn't end. It doesn't have an ending. It kind of just, like, cuts off at a point that feels almost kind of random, like, literally at the third act. Like, if they paced the movie better, they could have actually finished it and made, like, an actual complete film, but I guess they just decided not to do that. Like, it's not like Avengers Endgame, soy boy alert. I know in Avengers Infinity War where the movie ends, and it, you know, it's just, it's like, not satisfying. It's supposed to lead into the next one, but it feels like an actual, like, ending, you know, like a proper ending to the film, to the point where it's not, like, where it feels complete, even though it's still, like, connected to another one. This is literally just randomly ending it off at a certain point in the third act, assuming because they were on a deadline, the people who were making it, and they just wanted to get it out at a certain point, for the summer box office money, and instead of actually completing the movie. So that's fun. But yeah, I feel like for the first 10 minutes, it goes into the backstory of Gwen, and I think that's neat. It's very neat. I did enjoy some of the stuff there. I like the scene where Peter Parker is defending Spider-Woman, or Spider-Gwen, whatever the fuck her name is, to her dad, who's a police officer, and is talking about why she's a vigilante, which is a reference to The Amazing Spider-Man, I think, where the same thing happens, except he's defending himself to Gwen's father. You know, it's very neat. I'm someone who really loved that movie as a kid, and I do enjoy all the references to it, because I feel like it deserves more love. It is kind of a mid-film. It's just mid. It's not great, but, you know, I feel like we should recognize it, because, yeah, it's some okay parts. But, yeah, outside of that, that did not need to be in the movie. The first, like, 10 minutes are a total waste of time that didn't need to be here. Number one, Gwen isn't the main character of the movie. This movie isn't about her, it's about Miles. So the opening of the film should be about Miles, so it can establish the conflict of the movie in relation to himself, instead of establishing Gwen's backstory, which isn't something that's necessarily a core element of the film. I appreciate it, and I feel like they could go more in depth about it later, and maybe a third film or later in this film, but they really should have just started with Miles fighting the Spot. The whole scene, or series of scenes, did not need to be in the movie, especially the part where Miguel O'Hara and Spider-Woman come in, because number one, it kind of spoils the surprise, or I guess, part where Gwen meets Miles again. Number one, that could have been like a cool scene where you're like, oh, why is she back? And then she could explain, and it's like, wow, that's cool, you know. And it kind of destroys the suspense, because you already know she's gonna meet him again because the multiverse shit or whatever. So again, it also spoils Miguel O'Hara, who, again, they could have waited to put him in the film to build up his presence a little bit, but instead they introduce him in like literally the first 20-30 fucking minutes. And it kind of destroys his mystique, because they make him out to be a little bit of an idiot rather than a badass, which I feel like they tried to portray him later in the film. So, yeah, the entire first part of the film just didn't need to be there. It was kind of pointless. It kind of undercut later parts of the film. It didn't work well as a, you know, part of the film. It didn't set up the film as I feel like it should, you know. And also, it just wasn't super entertaining to watch, so. And again, the film takes too long to get to what the point of it actually is, which is Miles wanting to save his dad and him not being able to because it's a canon event or whatever, and then he gets hunted down. It takes like halfway through the film for that to actually happen, and I don't think it needed to be like that. They could have paced the film better, and they could have got to that point within the first act instead of pushing it off the half of the film, and then they might have actually been able to finish the movie. Crazy idea. So the pacing of the film is pretty bad. I mean, that should go without saying, because, you know, the pacing of a film is really bad when you need to separate it into two arbitrarily, because you don't want it to be too long, because you don't know how to pace the fucking movie. Yeah, just it's bad. It's really poorly paced, is what I'm trying to say. I think the second most important part why this movie isn't as good as everyone says is that it's not funny. It's not funny at all. The movie feels the need to destroy all tension it might have with some sort of unfunny joke. It does this all of the time in action scenes. A perfect example is when, you know, the Spot... Is that his actual name? I don't think I'm saying his name right. He's chasing the Spot, you know, and then the Spot is going on a monologue or something. He runs towards Miles, and then he trips and falls into himself, and it destroys all tension which could have been in that scene. And it does this constantly. If you watch the movie, you'll see it, and I guess, you know, if you're going to do it like a drinking game about this movie, take a drink every time it destroys attention with a shitty joke, because you'll destroy your liver. Again, it's not funny, and it does nothing but make the movie feel like a joke. Because it doesn't take itself seriously, so why should I care, you know? And again, I feel like this is a movie that really wants you to, you know, like, try and get invested, but I'm sorry, I can't, because they're making unfunny jokes every time it's getting suspenseful until halfway through the film, and I don't care anymore. Another thing is that they kind of boil some characters down to having having one note personalities, and they say one thing, and it's not funny at all. So the first one is Miles' Hispanic mother. That's a weird introduction to a segment of a video. So, in the you might not know this. This might be a little bit of a red pill for everyone watching, but his mom is Puerto Rican, and so is he. And, you know, I rewatched the movie a little bit, the first one, that is. I didn't finish it because every time I try and watch the movie, I kind of just get bored and leave. It's not a bad movie either. I thought it was pretty good. At least the parts that I watched, I kind of just got bored, but that's besides the point. I was able to intuit that Miles is part Hispanic and that his mother is Hispanic as well. When I first watched the movie and I was a retarded kid in 2018, I was like 11. That's not something I noticed, but I rewatched it and I noticed he spoke Spanish and stuff with his mom. And I thought that was really neat that they kind of gave this element of his identity and his heritage and his like social class subtly with having him speak Spanish with his mom. And they just don't tell us that, and they let us, you know, use our brains to notice it instead of feeding it down our throats like we're small children, which is something that this movie does. And with the jokes with his mom, they do this a couple times, but they just tell us that she speaks Spanish. They tell her, guys, this character is from Puerto Rico. Isn't that cool? The character is Hispanic. Guys, guys, guys. It's literally like an illumination to your joke. So again, in the first part, they're having an interview at Miles' school, and then they say Miles didn't do well in Spanish, and then she gets shocked. She's surprised, like, you guys don't know Spanish? I'm so angry at him. Like, why do you care? I mean, he's literally spoke Spanish with you multiple times, so you know he knows how to speak it. And even if you're Spanish, why do you give a shit? Like, why? Who cares? You know? Like, who cares? You know? She gets, like, overly offended because he doesn't know how to speak Spanish, and they try to make a joke out of it because it's like, so she's Puerto Rican and she's Hispanic and he doesn't do well in Spanish class, so she's offended. Funny. And again, later in that literal exact same scene, she says, well, I'm from the country, I'm from Puerto Rico. Did you know Puerto Rico is part of the United States of America? Again, you didn't need to say that out loud. It'd be better if you just let people intuit, you know, use their intuition to see it with clues from the actual film instead of just spoon-feeding it to us like we're small children. And also, that just feels like brownie points, pointing out the fact that Puerto Rico is technically part of the United States of America, and people who come to America from Puerto Rico are technically not immigrants because that is a part of the United States of America. Like, again, they do this again. She doesn't like one, so she says, I bet she doesn't even speak Spanish. And it's like, you know, if you could have just said that she looks like a punk or something, you know, because like that makes her kind of look kind of racist, actually. And also, it makes her look like a bad mom, because it's like, if she doesn't like this girl her son is going out with, and the first thing she thinks is she probably doesn't know how to speak Spanish because she's white, it's like, what? She kind of looks like a punk, you know, she looks like a punk rock girl. They could have said something about that, you know, she might be a bad influence or something basic like that, instead of having her say the one thing that she says in the movie, which is the fact that she is Hispanic and Puerto Rican, and that is a funny joke-o. It's like, stop this shit. Stop doing this. Again, another character they do this with is with the Scarlet Spider, who they make a edgy, emo, 90s stereotype. And honestly, I feel so bad for Ben Reilly fans, you know, because it's like, he's been done so dirty. He was introduced in the Clone Saga, which was ass. And then now he's in a new popular Spider-Man movie for the very first time. And they literally just turn him into an entire joke instead of having him be an actual character. He's a caricature. So they just totally disrespect the character and disrespect the fans who actually might like him. And it's like, come on, guys. It's not even that funny. It's not even original or clever. Do something with the actual character instead of making him a caricature that shits on the fans of the character. Like, guys, come on. Yeah, so anyways, that's the reason why I thought those are the reasons why I think the movie is just okay. And yeah, if you disagreed with me, I guess, and if you have anything actually like valid to say that's like constructive criticism towards the points that I made here, I'm actually fine with that. I know I've made fun of people who disagree with me in like the film more than I do in the video, but honestly, if you have any real actual criticism towards what I've said today in this video, then I'd actually appreciate that. So yeah, if you agreed with me or enjoyed the video, then thanks for watching, I guess. And even if you didn't, then thanks for listening to my opinions, which you disagreed with. A lot of people don't do that, so thanks, I guess.